In Matthew 2, we read of the wise men who came bearing gifts for the young Jesus. This most likely occurred just shortly before Mary and Joseph fled to Egypt to escape from Herod's murderous plot to kill the children of Bethlehem. Thus, these great gifts most likely helped to finance their trip through the wilderness to safety. Traditionally, there were three wise men because there were three gifts: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All three of these items were highly valued in ancient culture. Only the wealthiest could afford them. Yet these gifts, given to the Savior at his birth, were also very symbolic in nature. Though gold was significant in many ways, I only wish to discuss the two gifts of frankincense and myrrh. Frankincense and myrrh are both made from tree sap and are used for various types of incenses and ointments. The sap is collected by cutting or whipping the trees to cause them to bleed. The sap is then allowed to dry and then harvested from off the tree. Both frankincense and myrrh were known for their healing powers and were combined with oil and other spices to create healing balms. Myrrh was used to mask the smell during the embalming process of the dead by wrapping this and other spices within the folds of the cloth that wrapped the dead body. According to John 19:39, we learn that myrrh was used in the burial process for the Savior. Frankincense was used in the tabernacle of Moses and the later temples in Jerusalem as one of the spices that was burned at the altar of incense. This incense that was burned in front of the veil that separated the priest from the Holy of Holies, or the presence of God, symbolized the prayers of the righteous. This incense was to be a sweet savor to the Lord, just as our prayers should be. How fitting that the gifts given by the wise men were in similitude to the gift the Savior gave in Gethsemane and on the cross. Just as it was that because of these gifts, Mary and Joseph would have the resources to flee from Herod, so it is that through Christ's sacrifice, we are enabled to flee from Satan to the safety of his atonement. It is through his stripes, Isaiah says, that we are healed. It is through his blood that brings a sweet savor to life and death. It is because of his blood shed in Gethsemane and from the blows from the whip that allow us to mask the sting of death through his triumphal resurrection. Just as these spices were used to heal the physical wounds of mortal life, so the atonement of Christ heals our spiritual wounds. The atonement helps bring relief to our pain and helps bring a sweetness to life's difficulties. Because of his prayer in Gethsemane and on the cross, our prayers can and will be heard by the Father. Our prayers become like a sweet savor to the Father because of the sacrifice of the only begotten Son. Let us this Christmas season give a gift like the wise men, a gift that is in similitude of his sacrifice, a gift of our heart to the Lord, and a gift of our service and love towards mankind. A gift, though meager in comparison to his gift, that will likewise change the hearts and souls of those around us.